There are two new Sith revealed in the book Star Wars Myths and Fables. This book contains stories from the outer reaches of the galaxy that may be false or embellished, so in other words, these Sith may just turn out to be legends. On Moraband, which in ancient times was called Korriban, there is an infamous statue. This statue represents a Twi'lek standing on the edge of a mountain peak. No one really knows the history behind this figure, but there is one story that many people believe. The story begins over 1,000 years ago on Ryloth. Rhaenimis is born with a dark aura that alienates him from everyone but his mother. One day, a robed man shows interest in Rhae and convinces his mother to let him help the boy. This man, Darth Coldoth, explains that Rhae is strong in the Force and needs someone to guide him through his journey. Reluctantly, Rhae's mother lets him leave Ryloth with Darth Coldoth. Not long after Rhae becomes Darth Coldoth's apprentice, his master abandons him on the planet Simoth. There, Rhae is forced to fight in a gladiatorial arena. For 7 years, he harnesses his hatred and thrives as a champion. Darth Coldoth returns one day, and Rhae does not hold back. Rhae attacks Darth Coldoth, but stands no match for the Sith Lord in a melee. Darth Coldoth easily fends off Rhae, leaving him with a severed leku. Rhae then submits, accepting Darth Coldoth's invitation to continue his training. Rhae undergoes trials such as obtaining his lightsaber by slaying a female Jedi and bleeding her crystal. Rhae and Darth Coldoth become powerful over the years, searching for Sith artifacts and power from throughout the galaxy. Rhae soon becomes jealous of the power and knowledge that he feels Darth Coldoth is keeping from him. Rhae resents him for this and, in true Sith fashion, makes plans to betray his master. One day, Rhae sneaks into Darth Coldoth's private chambers to steal notes on a ritual. Rhae plans on using the ritual to trap Darth Coldoth in an eternal stasis. This fate would be even worse than death. However, Darth Coldoth foresees this and altered the notes before Rhae stole them. Rhae, unaware of his master's treachery, recites the ritual on the mountaintop in front of his master. To Rhae's shock, the ritual turns Rhae into stone. Some people like to call the statue the Weeping One, as sometimes it is said to cry an ebon tear. The statue is also known as the Silent Watcher and the Graven Lord. Whether this tale is true or not, it certainly is intriguing to learn of a relationship between an ancient Sith master and his apprentice. Either way, I'm excited that we are getting more stories set in the ancient times of the Sith. Let me know what you thought about the story in the comment section down below. Intrigued by the story? Make sure to check out my review of Myths and Fables. I talk about Star Wars on a weekly basis, so make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on future content. That is going to do it for me, Star Raptor. Thank you so much for watching, and may the Force be with you always. Thanks for checking out the video. Please hit that thumbs up symbol. It helps me know that I'm making content that you guys enjoy. And if you enjoyed this video, I also include 2 videos down below you guys should check out. And please consider subscribing to this channel. It helps support me and it notifies you guys of when I get new videos up on the channel. You can also contact me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram @StarRaptor.